Imagine being at the floor of a drilling or workover rig, with thousands of feet drilled beneath the surface of the earth, where the pressure and temperature are intense. What a wrong decision can cost. It can definitely lead to catastrophic consequences, from environmental pollution and production delay to costly equipment failure and fatalities. This is why it's extremely important to be aware of well control concepts, procedures, and equipment. In a series of videos, we will discuss and explore the science of well control. To identify the main purpose of well control, you have to understand basic terminology first. Starting with kick. A kick is the entry of an influx of formation fluid into the well. However, it's still under control. On the other hand, if this kick is ignored, it will keep flowing upward and expanding until it reaches the surface. Now the kick is no longer controlled. This is called a blowout. But the question is, how can a blowout lead to an uncontrolled fire? This follows the rule of the triangle of fire. A triangle of fire requires the presence of three conditions for a fire breakout. These are source of ignition, fuel, and oxygen. The source of ignition is represented by the friction due to the high speed of formation fluid exiting the well, or the presence of a source of ignition on site as diesel engines. The fuel is represented by the hydrocarbons produced by the formation, whether it's oil or gas. Since the formation fluid is now on surface, oxygen will be presented as well. This is how blowouts lead to the horrifying fires that are reported in major accidents in the oil and gas sector. But why does a kick originally take place? This question is answered by analyzing the different pressures that exist downhole. There are three main types of pressure that control the occurrence of a kick during normal drilling operations. These are: number 1, hydrostatic pressure. It is the pressure formed by the weight of the drilling fluid column. It is dependent on both drilling fluid weight as well as the height of the drilling fluid column. Number 2, the annular pressure losses, or APL. This is the pressure generated due to the friction force between the drilling fluid and the annulus during bombing and circulation. The APL plus hydrostatic pressure are called bottom hole pressure. Number 3, the formation pressure, or pore pressure. This is the pressure of the formation fluid contained inside the pores of the formation. Now pause this video and take a moment to think, what is the right equation that prevents the occurrence of a kick? The right equation is hydrostatic pressure equal formation pressure plus overbalance, which generates two more questions. Question number 1, what is an overbalance? An overbalance is a safety factor or an extra pressure that is required to exceed the formation pressure so that the well is still under control in case anything goes wrong, like a fault calculation in mud weight or a reduction in drilling fluid column height due to losing drilling fluid to porous formations. A common overbalance value in the oil and gas industry ranges from 100 to 200 psi. It can be higher or lower based on each specific case. Question number 2. Why does the previous equation ignore the effect of APL? This is because it's the right decision to assume the worst case scenario in well control to eliminate any risks. The worst case in normal drilling operations is when the circulation is stopped. This causes the APL to decrease to zero. That's why it is ignored in the previous equation. Now it becomes obvious that the kick will be taken when the formation pressure is higher than the hydrostatic pressure. However, significantly increasing hydrostatic pressure may also indirectly lead to a kick. That's because an extremely high hydrostatic pressure may cause fracturing of a weak formation. This will cause a severe loss in drilling fluid and hence decrease in the fluid column height. As a result, the hydrostatic pressure will drop, causing the occurrence of a kick. Finally, there is another type of kicks that may be taken during trapping the drill string out of the hole. This is called swab kick. Imagine withdrawing a medicine out of a vial using syringe. This is exactly what happens when you pull out of hold with a high speed. But this time, the vial is the formation, the medicine is the formation fluids, and the syringe is the drill string. In this type of kicks, the will may still be overbalanced depending on the size of the kick. The kick didn't occur because of a loss in overbalance, but due to suction effect of the drill string. There are plenty of signs and indicators that can be observed. Kick signs are just warning signs that a potential kick might happen. However, kick indicators are a proof that a kick has been taken indeed. Kick signs are: number 1. Increase in ROB, or rate of penetration. This is because a kick is usually received from an abnormally pressurized zone. This zone will tend to have higher formation pressure, hence higher volumes of fluids and higher porosity. So these formations are more drillable due to lower formation density. In addition, cuttings are usually circulated easily across these formations. That is because of a lower chip hold down pressure. This pressure is the difference between hydrostatic pressure and formation pressure, and it holds cuttings at the bottom of the well, which makes them drilled more than once, and consequently will reduce ROB. Since it's lower in case of abnormal zones, the ROB will be higher. Number 2. Increase in drag and torque, due to higher ROB and higher generated cuttings. Number 3. Increase in background gas level, due to higher formation pressure, which causes the exit of higher levels of gas during drilling. Number 4. Increase in flow line temperature. This is because heat conductivity of fluid is considerably lower than that of rocks. Since the fluid proportion in abnormal zones is higher, it means lower conductivity of heat from the rock, which means that heat is stored within the fluids without much dissipation. When the drilling fluid gets in contact with the formation fluid, its temperature will increase, causing a subsequent increase in flow line temperature. Number 5. The observation of large and angular cuttings on the shale shaker. This is due to cavings from abnormal zones into the well. On the other side, kick indicators are: increase in drilling fluid bit level, increase in rate of flow return on the flow line, and the presence of a return when the rig bumps are turned off. This is because a kick has been taken, causing displacing of an equal volume of drilling fluid out of the well. In addition, gas kicks tend to expand during migration upward due to lower pressure, causing even more and more displacement of drilling fluid. In this video, we have discussed the difference between a kick and a blowout, causes of a kick, and kick warning signs and indicators. So if you like this video, make sure to press the like button. Also share it with your friends for their benefit. If you want to know more about well control procedures and equipment, make sure to subscribe to our channel. Moreover, drop a comment in the section down below if you want to know more about any specific topic in the oil and gas field. Thanks for watching.